From today, couples in England and Wales can now apply for a no-fault divorce, finally ending the blame game for those wishing to split amicably. It will also mean that both parties will be given a minimum 20-week cooling-off period to work through their differences before committing to the separation. So what do we think of these reforms, Carol? I mean, it does seem like it can all be done with relatively quickly. That doesn't maybe always work for a couple, though, does it? There are lots of things to work out sometimes.
Yeah, I don't want to make life easy for any... difficult, I mean, for anybody. I really don't. But at the same time, I don't like this. I don't like it.
Why, though?
I feel like it's... If you make it easier to get divorced, people won't think twice about just getting married because, like, well, I can get divorced next week and I don't have to have a reason. I can just... If I get bored... I can get divorced. I don't think it's good because I think it is, I don't know, it's kind of disrespectful to the institution of marriage. And I know that's really old-fashioned, but I
but
am...
You are.
I am like
but
that, I am old-fashioned.
You can still get divorced, even if they didn't bring this
no,
up.
No, you
People
can.
Still get divorced,
I know, but
as we both know.
But why do they need to make it easier?
Well, I think because I went
really.
Through that horrible... when I got divorced from Ray... You know, we were both... There was nothing, really. We'd both come to the end, basically. But because I filed for divorce, I had to give a reason. So it had to be, like, adultery or unreasonable behaviour. So obviously I picked unreasonable behaviour, even though it wasn't really. But then I had to list five examples of it. And it was really hard. And I said, but there isn't. We just don't want to be together anymore. And they were going, no, you have to, or you can't, or you'll have to wait 2 years or 5 years. And we were both at a time when we then just wanted it out and done and finished.
So what did you say? Something
so
like he leaves his
say,
wet towels on the bed
literally
or
had
things
to,
like that?
I had to list things like that. He ignores me when I get in from work or he does this or he does that. And it was all that I felt. I had to phone him up and go, look, when because they obviously send it then to him. And I was like, when you get this, just know that I had to do it. Otherwise, we
can't
move forward.
And do you want to write it for yourself?
And I just didn't want to do that. I just wanted to just go, we've come, we're done.
But doing that means you can get divorced quicker, right? Because otherwise you have to live separately for 2 years before this law was brought in. Or you have to wait, I don't know if it's five or 6 years. It's 5 years, is it? 5 years for a no-fault divorce. And then you can just get divorced.
But I don't want to wait 5 years.
You waited 5 years, even though the other party wanted the divorce.
Yeah.
And why did you do that?
Well, because I wanted to make him wait.
So it was
so
like
you
retaliation.
Used it as a weapon.
Yeah. Well, you know, I've said it before, and I've said it in the book I wrote 10 years ago. It was basically because he'd been in control the whole time in the relationship, and he wanted control over that as well. He didn't even ask me for a divorce. He just got someone to phone me up and say, so-and-so wants a divorce.
Well,
and
here's
I just
the thing,
went,
though.
Well, no.
What about somebody who is being physically or mentally terribly abused?
Yeah.
And goes, I want a divorce, then that abuser knows that, well, I'm not going to give it to you. You'll have to wait.
Yeah.
Surely that's better for them to be able to go in.
Yeah.
Look, here's the point. As of today, in a way, everything we're talking about changes, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Because
today.
It's easier. Yeah. But if two people want to get divorced, if they're very amicable about it all and they want to get divorced, of course, they can get it really, really quickly now, can't they? Mm. So it works for people like that.
If it's amicable,
because they're in
yeah.
agreement. They're in agreement of it. But where I have issue with it, and I agree with you to a point, I think you can make divorce and everything just too easy because most marriages have hiccups and it's not allowing you any time to work your way through
it is, really.
Difficulties. It's not really.
I mean, you don't go in and get your divorce the next day.
But, Coleen, here's the point. If it's only 5 months from start to finish, when you think of everything you've built up as you've been married and you have children and you have assets and you have money to sort out, I mean, how do you do all of that amicably and simply in 5 months?
Because I think you do it easier if you haven't gone, you did this and you did this, and it becomes a blame game all the way through.
No, but I mean,
think that's where it causes animosity.
As my
that's
lawyer said, he spends more time sorting out who gets the tea set that Joan bought than anything else. I mean, you end up fighting with trivial things. But, I mean, one thing that shocked me with divorce was, and it was like a 2-year wait and then divorce, but my youngest son, Michael, was about 12, I think, at the time. And I hadn't anticipated this in a way, but once a child is over a certain age, I think that's probably still the age, the judge has to say to them, take them away, and, or as I had to go away into an ante room, who would you like to live with? Do you want to live with your dad or your mum? And in a way, I hadn't sort of anticipated that. So I sat in the ante room, being selfish, of course. I wanted him to stay with me, and thank God he did. Mm. But there are many, many issues. Mm-hmm. You cannot package all marriages and all divorces and everything into a five-month period.
I mean, if you know that you're coming to an end and both parties, it's an amicable, sort of an amicable setup, and then you go into the divorce knowing it's all done potentially in 26 weeks, that works. I guess there will be couples, though, where maybe someone's been having an affair, the other partner's at home, doesn't know a thing, they think they're kind of living their normal married life, and suddenly they come home and go, I want a divorce. And within 26 weeks, it's done.
Yeah. That's a shock.
Without you being able to contest or ask even for a reason.
Or even process that in that kind of...
Yeah, that's what I mean. The processing time, potentially, for some people it doesn't work. For your setup, I completely get that it's an absolute relief that you don't have to go through 2 to 5 years
of
trying.
But what about if someone's having an affair, you find out and they don't want a divorce? But you do, because they've been having an affair.
Absolutely.
But you see, divorce anyway is ugly.
It's horrible.
It's never nice.
It's horrible. It's ugly.
And it's heartbreaking.
Yeah. Of course it is, no matter what.